Welcome to Norfolk Perspective City Slice. I'm Bob Batcher, and yes, the holidays are around the corner, which means Mary Miller's on the sofa to talk about
Grand Illumination Parade and holidays in the city.
And this time you brought a friend with you, Jessica Kilner, Director of Marketing for DNC. Yes. And Mary, you are now, is this the first time you've come on as president?
No, I was on earlier this year with you as president, but this is the first time as president for the parade.
That's right.
Yes.
Well, which means you'll no longer be the new president of DNC once the parade's over.
That's right.
But it's so much more than the parade. It's the whole holidays in the city, the 6 weeks, right?
Right.
6 weeks of events in downtown Norfolk and Old Town Portsmouth. So there's a lot to do. 6 weeks until the first of the year.
Now, okay, the parade's been done. This is the
29th? Yes.
Mm-hmm. Should we start talking about the 30th?
No, not yet.
Let us get through this one.
Well, okay, come on, guys. It ought to be a piece of cake by now.
Right, we've 29 times.
Yeah. So what's different this year? The theme?
The theme is different. It's a Jingle Bell Jungle this year, so that you're going to, you know, see toucans and all kinds of fun jungle references throughout. So it'll be a lot of fun.
Well, let me cut right to the chase then. How do you communicate jungle, holidays? How are you getting the word out?
Well, we do it a lot of ways, but one is a video that we'll talk about our street seats, when that's kind of the ultimate parade experience where you can sit in a seat on the parade route. So those are available for anyone to purchase now through the parade. So I took a look at the video.
And you've had some special guests kind of talk about this, haven't you? Let's show that.
What you doing?
Hey, Tarzan. It's not the law of the jungle, but if you want to guarantee a great view of the 29th annual Grand Illumination Parade, Saturday, November 23rd at 7 p.m., then reserve your street seats.
Street seats? What day?
Street seats are the ultimate parade experience. You can get VIP seats for only $25, and general admission is just $10.
Visit downtownnorfolk.org to reserve your seats today.
Kids under four can sit in your lap.
It Jingle Bell Jungle out there. I tell Jane order tickets today.
Good idea, Tarzan, but seats are limited, so buy yours today.
It's easy. You can print them off straight from home.
Cool, Jack. Won't you melt in jungle?
He's a beauty. In jungle!
You know, I'm not really sure where to go from there. You're using that on social media.
We're using that all over social media, just to get people excited about the parade and kind of our theme and ready.
But it's kind of cool, though, because I think it represents what this parade really is about. It's a celebration of the local community.
Yes.
And that's the hurrah players, which we have today. And they did Tarzan a few months ago. So it's right down their alley. Who else are you kind of tying in on the parade?
I mean, we have, we have lots of bands, we have floats again, obviously, walking units.
There's over 75 units, and we have bands that represent the entire South Side. So we have Virginia Beach, Richmond, every band. There's 9 bands, so there's a lot of fun to be had watching the bands.
Okay, now I know, in a little inside baseball, the Tide kind of gave us some new challenges a couple of years ago.
Yes.
So are there going to be balloons?
Yes. So we do, and the balloons will be themed around, you know, kind of the jungle idea as well. So we have the great giant helium balloons, and they're a lot of fun, and because we did change the parade route, you know, we don't have any conflict with light rail. So.
That's right. Now, where are those seats going to be?
Well, the street seats are located, it's a 2-mile-long parade route, and so there's just strategically placed throughout the route in groups. So they're on Main Street, on Granby Street, so there's a bunch of different options for those seats. So
the main thing is go online and just
go online, order them, and then you have a guaranteed reserve seat. But there's plenty of seating. As I said, it's 2 miles long, so there's seats, you know, whether you reserve your street seat and kind of have that ultimate experience or you just walk down, there's lots of great seating.
And one thing I've discovered, having seen the whole thing, because I got tricked into doing step off one time.
Yeah.
So I've seen the route the whole way. We won't talk about that publicly, but there's really no bad place to sit, and there's some really secret places where you think the band is going to quiet down, but they don't. I mean, there's an energy level throughout the whole route.
Yeah. Right.
There's a great energy level.
Get down early?
There's so much to do downtown. There's no reason not to come down early. You can have a nice dinner, you can go shopping, you can get the early bird parking rates because it's $1 from 3 to 5.
Wait a minute, you want to say that again? Because the parade's free.
Right.
Yes.
You could park downtown?
For a dollar.
Starting when?
From 3 to 5 p.m. you can park for a dollar. That's the early bird rates. And then once you're down there, there's free entertainment. There's all kinds of things going on the parade route.
You know, it never fails. The day after the parade, you get that letter to the editor saying they got stuck on 264.
Mm-hmm.
Part of me thinks it's because they didn't take advantage of the early bird special and come down early.
Right, and then there's alternate modes of transportation. You can take the tide in, so you can park out, you know, at one of the park and ride facilities.
And let the party begin there.
Yes, and take the train, the light rail train into downtown.
Okay, so the day of the parade is going to be?
Saturday, November 23rd.
Now that's a little later.
Yes.
Than usual, but it's always the Saturday before Thanksgiving.
Correct. Yeah.
Okay. So you come down for the parade. What other kinds of things can you come down for during the 6 weeks of the holidays?
Well, you can go to our website, downtownnorfolk.org, and there's a huge list.
Like,
I would be here all day telling you all the stuff there is.
That's really good because somebody's going to be out there saying, she didn't mention my event, because it really
right.
is a collaboration.
It's
of
a collaboration.
A whole bunch of
people. We really would be here for a long time if we listed out everything there is to do. But there's the MacArthur Center Winter Carnival, there's the Scottish Walk in Old Town Portsmouth.
Wait a minute.
Read some off from there.
Okay, let me see. Keep going. You're doing good.
Mary's turn.
Well, there's the 13th annual Pagoda and Garden Light Fest, the Polar right. Express, TCC Performing Arts. There's How About Hanukkah? So there's something
right.
for everybody.
Virginia Stage Company, their traditional Christmas carol, Hurrah Players does the best Christmas pageant ever, and Hurrah for the Holidays. So lots
Zelda
and lots
Handmaid
of stuff.
Fair.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Kwanzaa celebration.
Right.
The Christmas Addicts on December 26th. And I've got to mention this. December 14th, the Virginia Symphony Holiday Pops.
Right.
Got to go to that.
Yeah.
There's some cool. So where do you get these?
Those are located all throughout downtown. They're at hotels. They're at businesses. You can find them downtown. You could come pick one up from us or just, like I said, go to the website because that's just a sampling of events because we couldn't fit them all here. So we just got people
right.
excited. And then mm-hmm. our website really is a great resource for just any and everything there is to do downtown during the holidays.
Okay, Mary, what's the name of the show? Norfolk Perspectives, right?
Yes.
It's all about Norfolk, right?
Yes.
But Holidays in the City will get me broader than just Norfolk.
Yes, because it is about bringing the holidays to Hampton Roads. So the Grand Illumination Parade does kick off the, you know, what has become a holiday tradition in Hampton Roads. And as Jessica mentioned, we have just, you know, participants in the parade from all over the region, which is fabulous.
Now, Portsmouth is also kind of...
And they're our partner, right. So this is, I think, their 16th year of being our partner. So there's activities, you know, in Old Town Portsmouth as well. They'll participate in the parade. And, you know, we have a great opportunity. You can go between our respective downtowns by ferry, which is a great way to get around.
Now, a major part of the play or of the parade is at 7 p.m. exactly.
Yes.
Something happens downtown.
Yes, magically, all of the skyline in downtown Norfolk and Old Town Portsmouth is illuminated.
So after 29 years...
The magic continues.
The elf ought to know how to do it, right?
Yes, yes.
And they all go, right?
Does it always happen? Come on, does it always happen?
The elves, yes. How do they get all those presents made? You know, it's just, yes, they can make it happen.
And we're going to leave it at that.
Yes.
Right.
But let's talk about partnerships. That's really what makes us go, right?
Right. And, you know, we couldn't do this parade without the city of Norfolk as a partner. There's so many logistics that people who see the event just don't understand what goes on behind the scene. From, you know, from public works to the police department, the fire department, the city's special events office. I mean, everybody that really pitches in and has meetings with us beginning in the summer to put this event on. It's a huge undertaking.
I was going to say, when do you start planning?
We plan it all year long, but we actually will start logistics meetings in August. And, you know, we're fortunate to still continue a wonderful partnership with ABC 13, WVEC here locally, who does broadcast the parade live as well.
But there's nothing better than
seeing it on the street, right?
Because there is a parade between commercial breaks.
That's right.
Yes, there is. And then, you know, we like that they broadcast it live, but then you have a chance to see it again, because they'll broadcast it again sometime, you know, before the end of the year, and you can just relive all
the
fun.
Well, and guess what? Right. Yeah. You can watch it on TV 48.
That's right.
Between Christmas and New Year's.
Yeah.
Every time, too.
Yeah. It's very fun.
Well, we are so glad that you decided to come do it again, even though it's the 29th year. And you have to do it again every year brand new.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But what's the theme for next year?
We actually do know it, but it's going to be...
You're not going to tell me.
No, not yet.
No. Oh, it's going to be a big unveiling, and yeah.
Okay, well, let me say thank you to you all for watching. Now share it with me. What is it next year? Okay.